Hello and welcome to this tutorial. I'm Robin from DxO, and in this video, I'll demonstrate some of the new Nik Collection workflow features. There are many workflows possible in the Nik Collection, and all are fast and intuitive. This makes working with the Nik tools easy and enjoyable, allowing you to focus on the creative side of photography. To finish editing a photo, we often need to edit an image in more than one Nik application. This can slow you down and break your concentration as you're forced to close and then reopen the image in a different plugin. But in the Nik Collection 7, we have a new plugin switcher. This makes switching between the different Nik applications easy in many situations. After editing this image in Nik Color Effects, I can switch to another using the Switch To button. We now see a list of the plugins where I can choose Nik Silver Effects Pro. When the image opens, I'll apply one of the Silver Effects presets. Then I'll switch to the Nik Output Sharpener to sharpen the finished image. Finally, I'll end my workflow and return to Photoshop. Now you can see several new layers have been added to the image, one for each time I switch to a different plugin. This also works the same with Photoshop Elements. If you're using the Nik Collection in Lightroom or standalone, the changes are applied directly to the image because layers aren't supported. In that situation, you may want to use the new Quick Export feature. Let's edit our image again, but in the standalone version of Color Effects Pro, while I explain how it works. Because my changes are saved to the JPEG file I'm editing, I should have made a copy to work with. If you forget to do this, it's not a problem as we can make a copy using the Quick Export button. This exports the current image to the same folder as the file we're working with. I can then continue to apply my changes in Color Effects Pro. Then, because these changes will be saved to the image when I switch plugins, I'll click the Quick Export button again to save another copy. I can then switch to Silver Effects Pro to apply more changes. If we look at the folder containing the image I was editing, we see the files the Quick Export produced. You may also have noticed how quick the Nik Collection is to work with. These applications are fast to launch and feel snappy when editing. That's because the Nik Collection 7 has been optimized for speed. Many of the Nik applications come with large collections of filters and presets. In addition, you can save your own presets to work with in the future. Nik Color Effects Pro is a good example with a large library of both filters and presets. Fortunately, there are several features to help us manage these. For example, we can mark regularly used filters and presets as favourites by clicking the star icon on the left. It's then possible to restrict the list to show only the items marked as favourites. There's also an option to show the recently used filters, which we can combine with the favourites option. In the preset list, you'll find these same features. If you know part of the name of a preset, you can search for it in the new search bar. Then only the presets containing the word I'm searching for are shown. This also does the same with the filter list. Something else we see is that the filters and presets are organised into categories. When we select a category, we sort the list to show only the items in that category. As with the filters and preset list, we can mark categories as favourites. It's also possible to add new filters and presets to different categories, as well as create completely new categories. Using these features makes managing large numbers of filters and presets quick and easy in the Nik Collection 7. Now you're ready to use the Nik Collection tools in a workflow that suits you best. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our website, nikcollection.dxo.com.